Hi, my name is Sara, and I'm a planetary scientist. A planetary scientist is someone who studies pretty much anything that's in space, including our Earth, moons, other planets, and even stars. A main part of my job is to study impact craters on the moon. When an asteroid hits the surface of the moon, it excavates a lot of rocks and sand that then create an ejecta blanket. My research is to try and find ages for craters on the moon. I use temperature data from a spacecraft that's been orbiting the moon called the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. We try and see how old those craters are, which tells us when that asteroid hit the moon. Having a full history of how often the moon has gotten bombarded by these asteroid impacts gives us a good clue that the Earth has experienced the same bombardment around the same time as well. The Earth has an atmosphere, which acts like a protective shield going around the entire planetary body. So only really large asteroids can burn through the atmosphere and actually impact the Earth. But some planetary objects, such as our moon, don't have an atmosphere, so a lot more asteroids can bombard the moon. Since the moon has formed, there have been over 1 billion asteroid impacts. Because the moon and the Earth formed around the same time, about 4.5 billion years ago, the moon and the Earth share the same impact history. The Earth has a lot of weathering effects, like snow, rain, erosion, tectonic activities, so it erases a lot of the older impact craters. So it makes it a lot harder to go back in history and find all the craters on the Earth. Because the moon doesn't have weathering activities, nothing gets erased on the surface of the moon. So the moon is a great time capsule for every event that's ever happened on the moon or anything around the moon, which includes our Earth. Now we're gonna make our own impact craters to see what asteroid impacts look like on the moon. You can do this at home. All you need is some flour, a bin to contain it, some cocoa powder, and something to act like your asteroid. It could be rocks or pebbles, or even some marbles. You may also want to wear some safety goggles. All right, I've got my flour in the bin, and now I'm gonna add some cocoa powder to the top to represent the top layer or the surface of the moon. Make sure you cover all the flour with cocoa powder. I'm gonna shake it a little bit to make sure everything is spread out evenly. Okay, now we're gonna create our impact craters. I'm gonna start with my small rock and just drop it at this height. Okay, I'm gonna remove my rock gently, and the hole that it's left behind, that circular feature, is our impact crater. And we see some of the flour splashed out as well. When an asteroid hits the surface of the moon, it brings out a lot of material, fresh rocks, and some sand from beneath the surface. This is what we call our ejecta blanket. Now you can see that most of the ejecta is distributed equally around the crater, so a lot of the rocks and the sand seem to be in a circular pattern around our crater. Now this is fairly a small size crater. I'm gonna try to see if I can get a different size crater if I use a bigger rock. I'll drop it from the same height. Our new impact crater is larger than the first impact crater we got. It's because we used the larger rock. Again, a lot of the rocks and the sands seem to be in a circular pattern, but if I compare the two, I can see a lot more flour, which in this case are those rocks and sand that have been splashed out. But what if we have an asteroid that hits from a different angle? I'm gonna give it a try and see what my other crater might look like. Have a look at that. You can see that all of my ejecta is splashed in the other direction. So if I have an impactor coming from this angle, it's gonna splash out a lot of material in the same direction. Not all asteroid impacts come in the same direction. They could hit the surface of the moon at very different angles. Looking at the ejecta around craters can also tell us at what angle the asteroids hit the surface of the moon. The best part of my job is that I get to see pictures and images from other planets and the moon that real space missions have taken, and I use them to answer a lot of questions about how different planets have formed and how they've changed over time. If we want to send astronauts or rovers to the moon, we first need to know where all the craters are so that we can make sure they land on the surface safely. This is super cool because I get to use this information for planning future space missions. When I was younger, I wanted to become an astronaut, but when I was in high school, I learned that there's no astronaut school. So then I decided to study space. I wanted to learn as much as I could about other planets, about stars, and make discoveries. If you also love space and want to become a planetary scientist, you should study math, science, physics, chemistry, biology, geology, and computer science. And visit different space agencies' websites to get a lot more resources and information. If you also love space, want to work with cool images from other planets, or help plan future space missions, you might want to become a planetary scientist too.